Welcome back, everybody. This is still Stand Up and Bite Me. We are still searching for Canada's next stand-up superstar. Your next comedian of the night, final one for this show. He was born in Sooke, B.C., still lives in Sooke, B.C. Please welcome to the stage, Kevin Banner.
I'm Kevin Banner from Sooke, B.C. When I found out this was going to be on TV, I started dieting this morning. And I've only cheated twice so far, so... What made me want to be a stand-up comic is I had a hole that I needed to fill, and donuts wasn't getting it done. I've been doing stand-up comedy for 6 years now. Got a dark sense of humor, but I'm not a dark guy. I just think it's funny when bad things happen. I think my family hates me because I'm the least successful of the three. I've given them the least. My brother's a business owner, and my sister gave them a grandkid, and I got a 5-minute spot the other night at the Chuckle Barn. Cool. I want to win this competition tonight because then people might think that I'm actually doing something with my life. I'm not, but it'd be nice if they thought that I was, right? My pre-show routine is to look at a piece of paper covered with notes and say, I stink. And then I just kind of go up and fulfill my prophecy. If I win the $10,000, I'm going to get a championship ring. Not that big. Diamonds. I'd like to wish everybody else in this competition good luck, but that would be disingenuous, so I won't. I want that money.
Is it bad that the walk up here winded me? Little bit about myself. I like chicken pot pie. Not in that order. Everybody got it who's gonna? Okay. The last girl I dated, she didn't really like it if I would smoke pot before we'd be intimate. I understand, you know, cotton mouth being what it is. No girls out there looking for the driest tongue in the world, but it put me in an awkward situation where, like, I had to pick between doing my favorite thing in the world or having sex with my girlfriend, and... All right. That was the sound of $10,000 leaving. I've been trying to quit smoking pot, and it's not easy. I went to a Narcotics Anonymous meeting recently. You ever want to feel like a zero, go to an NA meeting with your pot problem. Little advice, just lie. Tell them you're on glue or something, because they won't give you respect. There are people there with, like, legitimate drug problems. Like, this guy got up and he shared his story. He had lost his family, his job, his house, because of cocaine. And it was my turn to share. What have I ever lost from being too stoned? One time I lost my sunglasses. Yeah. Yeah, for like 20 minutes. I was wearing them. And I just thought it was nighttime. So in an effort to cut back on the weed, I've been drinking more. I do a lot of embarrassing shit when I'm drunk. Like, have you ever been cut off at the bar for being too drunk? That's embarrassing. They'll cut you off at the bar for being too drunk, but they won't cut you off at McDonald's for being too fat. And which would save more lives, folks? Like, if you look anything like a fridge, the appliance or the football player, and you place your order, they should have the right to refuse service. Like, yeah, I'll get a Big Mac meal supersized with a Coke. Are you kidding? No. You can have the lettuce from the Big Mac and the ice from the Coke. Why don't you try jogging? I call that joke the pot calling the kettle black. Jogging pants are a poorly named article of clothing. I own many pairs and I've never been. I think a better name for them might be like hangover pants, awkward strip club boner pants.
Get that guy a fanny pack.
Used to wear a black leather fanny pack because ladies like a bad boy. I do all of my clothes shopping at the Big and Tall because, as my doctor once told me, I have the metabolism of a corpse. And I think that's bad. I think it's funny you go into the Big and Tall, though. They've got, like, these fancy dress clothes up to a 10XL. Like, really nice, fancy clothes, but... If you're a 10XL, where are you going? Big night at Arby's? I mean, you can't go to the club. You're a fire hazard. And they're expensive, though. Those clothes cost a lot of money, especially when you factor in cutting out one of the walls of your house. and renting a crane. 10XL leather jackets. It looks like somebody just took all the stuffing out of a love seat.
It had a zipper on it. Somebody don't fucking buy it.
I think the reason that people get that big is that they make clothes that big. Like, if you just made it clear, hey, 4XL, that's still giving you some buffet trips. 4XL, that's the cutoff. After that, you're on your own. You gotta wrap up in a tarp. Cut holes in a barbecue cover. People will eat salad. Oh, a girl asked me recently what my fantasy was. She goes, what's your fantasy? So it's this. I'm coming out of a sporting goods store after buying a baseball bat, and I find a guy breaking into my car. She was disappointed. She thought it was going to be about fucking. I've done some fucking. I want to see what aggravated assault feels like. One more joke before I go. I'm almost out of time here. I like drinking, as I said. I created a fun little drinking game. I give it out to you, the people. Try it your own. I call it the McRace. What I do is I go to McDonald's. I drink half a bottle of Jägermeister in the parking lot. I go inside, I eat 2 quarter pounders, and then I try to beat my diarrhea home. You win some. You lose some. Ruin my favorite purple joggers. Hey, thank you guys. My name is Kevin Banner.
I went up and I gave them some of my best jokes and I did really mediocre. It was great. I felt like it was mediocre, but it wasn't that bad. But I was surprised because they looked really dumb out there. But they were good. They just looked like a stupid crowd, like a bunch of idiots, like long dumb looking faces. But they were good. They really were. And they tried. Vancouver is a fun place to do stand up because everybody is high. And me too. At this point in the competition, I think my chances are probably about 1 in 32, so I'm really, I'm not confident. I had a great time tonight doing my thing. I love doing stand-up. I do it for the same reason Mike Tyson takes Zoloft, to keep from killing y'all. Thanks.